friends, welcome back. In this session, we are going to understand what RFM is all about. RFM is one of the most easiest as well as most frequently used techniques in data analysis, and it is going to help you out in understanding your customers and to cluster your customers so easily. It is one of the very important topics that we people should learn when we go into data analytics and all the stuff, and that's what we are going to see today. RFM is actually a recency, frequency and monitoring. It has not suddenly come out to the market. It is there for a long time, and recently it has gained more focus because of the ability of RFM to give you a clear picture with a very limited amount of computation. These techniques will help you in understanding your customer better. That's the major focus that we need to understand about, and this helps you in understanding your customers pretty clearly. And
to make it very more clear, R refers to the recent purchases you made, F refers to the frequency of the purchases that you make, and M refers to the amount of money that you have spent on purchase. This will help you in understanding how much loyal the customers are, what is the capacity of the customer, I mean the buying ability, how frequently is the customer visiting, and all these details will help you in understanding your customer better, to have some scheme for promoting their buying, to have some scheme to pay more attention to the buyer who is more loyal, who is a potential large buyer, who is a most valued customer. All these things can be clearly understood and your business can enhance better. So these terms are together called as RFM, and it is one of the very important techniques that people use in the market. Now, there is a rule called as Pareto rule, which says 80% of your business comes from 20% of your customers. So RFM is fundamentally based on that, and RFM is fundamentally used to know the customer. Instead of analyzing the entire customer data set as one unit, here we are going to categorize it and cluster it as multiple smaller units so that they will become distinctive, and at the same time you can understand the customers of the similar category who have similar needs and similar buying ability with similar characteristics, which means you can devise a mechanism to focus on them perfectly. This will help us in improving our marketing performance. Most importantly, we can decide on our campaigns that we are going to make for the customers based on the clusters which they get in. So finally, this is a method that is used in a retail and consumer industry where we have a lot of data about the buyers, and we are understanding the customers through the RFM analysis, and we can accelerate business. Again, I tell you, the data is going to be the core part here. Without having a correct data entry, RFM will be a failure. You need to have a clear data set for you to understand your customer, which means that the data set is going to be the king here. Now, frequency is an indicator of customer's loyalty. How frequently he is visiting your shop, which means that he likes your shop so much, he is so loyal to the offers that you are giving, and he has got a connect with your shop. This shows customer's loyalty. Recency is the indicator of retention of the customer. How recent has he come? In the past, if I start analyzing that, I will also understand it is an indicator of the retention of the customer. And monetary is an indicator of customer's worth. How much he worth it? How much is the customer worth it? That's very important. If a customer is just buying items for, say, about 1 rupee, 10 rupees maximum, small components he buys every time, he might not be rated as a potential buyer. If he buys every time for, say, about 25,000 rupees, 30,000 rupees every time, whenever he comes and he visits very frequently as well, he is a buyer whom we need to retain. The retention of the buyer can be paid more attention if they are potential as well as loyal customers who are big buyers as well. So frequency, recency and monetary, all these three will help you to understand how loyal the customer is, how frequent the customer is, what is the capacity of the customer. All these three in one shot can be understood with RFM model. Now, recency will tell you the time interval between the customer's first and the last visit. Higher the interval is, more loyal a customer is. Average number of days between n recent visits date and the last date. That is the point that we need to remember here. And lower the average is, more recent the customer is. This is very, very important, which means he keeps visiting quite frequently. The recency is the data that tells you how much gap is there between the previous visit and the current visit. Frequency is the total number of visit between a particular time. So higher the frequency is the indicator of the higher loyalty. Monetary value is the scheme where we understand the big spending customer easily. I have a customer who has bought for say about 1.5 lakhs and every time he buys a lot of components and it goes the higher rate, and we need to categorize them as a higher potential buyer where he is also a big spender. So we need to understand that. And now, why do we need RFM analysis? The most recent the purchase, the most responsive the customer is to promotions, which means give them some more promo offers, get them to the next level and make them loyal. A customer has come, he has come recently, he has not purchased in the past also. I understand that he is impressed with our buying, impressed with our sales. Now I will give him some more promo code to make him a loyal customer. He has come recently, I need to understand, I need to make him loyal, give him some promotion. There is a customer who is coming frequently, who is a buyer as well. So give them special attention. There can be a customer-centric focus there. And finally, monetary value. They may expect a sophisticated treatment if they are a very rich buyer. They are going to be a big buyer. Yeah, they need special attention. They come one time, they need to be given special privileges. They can be called as privileged customer. And all these are understood using the RFM model. In short, who are the best, worthy, loyal customers? Who are having the potential to buy more? Who may be lost? I can also understand who is a potential customer who is going to be lost. Who could be given more attention to be retained and to make them permanent buyers? Which of the customers need campaigns, offers or promotions? Who are more susceptible to accept the promotions? Who are more susceptible to accept the offers? We need to understand all these, and this will help us in analyzing our customers better. Now you see here, this is the analysis that we have done with some data set, whatever I have got in hand. And I have analyzed it as best customer, big spender, loyal customers, recent customers, almost lost, last customers, last cheap customers and others. So I have analyzed it and I have given you a graph. This is what RFM will tell you. RFM will clearly tell you who are the customers who needs to be retained, who are the customers who are about to be lost, but they are good customers, which we definitely need to make. And this entire analysis is all done through my RFM analysis, RFM scoring. But how did we do it? We did it through Python. And this is a tabular tool that we are using to get you this much better graphical representation. And this is a very fundamental method that we are using for understanding the customer. I am going to take you through a sample data set that I myself have created. I have got 5 customers, A1, A2, A3, A4, A5. I have given some recency score. I have given some recency data, frequency data, monetary data. Recency is in days, frequency is in number, total value is the monetary representation. Now I need to give him R score. Now you see that this customer A3 has come recently. So I have put 1. 1 is the recent one. Now I keep incrementing it. 1, 2, 5, 7, 10. They are ordered. Now I need to give the rank. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 is the rank. First rank will get 5 as the R score. Second rank will get 4 as the R score. Third rank 3. Similarly, likewise, I have given the R score. This R score 5 is given to the most recent customer. I hope you understand this point. Now I'll go to the next one. I have got the frequency data here. So the most frequent visitors, I've got the entry here. I have got the data here, who are most frequently, number of times that they have visited is here. A1 is the customer who visited most frequently, who gets rank 1, who gets the 5 as the score. Similarly, I have ranked all the customers and I have given score. Now I'll go to the monetary value. In this data, who is the biggest purchase maker? The 6500 is the biggest purchase maker. I rate A5 as the rank 1. He got 5 score. Who is the second one? 3652. He will get the second score. Similarly, 2560, 1520. Likewise, I have rated them. Now, finally, what do I have is, I have R plus F plus M. 8, 11, 12, 6, 8 for all the 5 customers has been made. And when I take an average of this, I get the score of 2.66, 3.66, 4, 2 and 2.66. Now I understand which customer has got the highest RFM score, who needs to be paid more attention, who is going to be the lowest scorer and who needs some campaign, some promotion probably, is also identified using this data. And this is a very simple method but yet a very effective method for you to understand your customers. Once you analyze this, you'll get a clear clustering of best customers, big spenders, loyal customers, recent customers, almost last customers, etc. very clearly. With little bit of programming in hand, you can analyze this when the data set goes bigger. Since I have taken only 5 entries, I could do it manually, but I would prefer you to go with Python if you have a bigger data set. Soon, we shall meet again with the next better topic. Thank you very much for following the channel. If you have any queries, suggestions, inputs, please do not hesitate. Go ahead and type it in the comment section. If you like the channel, please subscribe. Thank you very much. Thank you for all the support that you people are giving me. Thank you.